Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So we are continuing with the WBCS series, and today we'll be telling you the routine which we are going to follow for the WBCS 2018 preliminary preparation. So we have already started the preparation, but we were not so regular. So what we have planned, we'll be uploading videos regularly so that it would help you. So we'll have a consistency we'll make a plan how will we make our preparation, and accordingly we'll move on. So if you follow my channel, maybe you'll be getting information that could help you for your preparation. And the students, the aspirants who are new, who have just started their preparation, they may go through my previous videos because those are helpful, and most of the people are writing me. And I'm also trying to help you. It's not like teacher and student relationship, it's like a friend. So we'll be friends, we'll be discussing topics, we'll be chatting, and at the same time, if you have any argument, you can argue with me. If I'm telling anything wrong, you can write it in the below comment section. Like that way, we'll make the session interactive, and it will be helpful for you. So let me come to the topic. So our target is WBCS 2018 preliminary examination. So for that we have a plan. So let me discuss the plan initially. So the plan is, we'll be teaching you economics in detail. We'll be teaching you Reserve Bank of India, Indian banking system, because we have seen so many questions are coming from economics nowadays, and people are neglecting economics. So you are preparing history, you are preparing geography, but you are neglecting economics. So we have a plan to focus on economics, RBI, Indian banking system, and then we'll move on to science and technology section. Because I have seen nowadays questions are coming more from these three sections, and most of the aspirants do not prepare this section. So our plan is to make you aware of economics, to make you aware of the terminologies, and to make you aware of the scientific and technological events which are going on. And then we'll move on to Indian polity. So we'll give you 100% coverage in these sections. And once we finish it, then we will come to geography. Now you know, in our WBCS, we have West Bengal geography. Because if you see the syllabus, then you can see it is written that geography of India with special reference to West Bengal. So we will be telling you the West Bengal geography, and then we will come to history section. In history, we have divided into three sections, like others, ancient, medieval, and modernist. Now you have a separate portion for your WBCS, and that is INM, Indian National Movement, that has 25 marks. So combinedly, if I say only history consisting of 50 marks, so whichever background you are from, you have to study history. That is the main thing. Then you have to select your strength. Suppose you are an economics student, so you can study Indian polity and economics. You can give more time to economics and Indian polity, RBI, banking system, etc. And then you can start your geography if you are weak in geography. But the thing is, you can't remove any subject, because you have to you have to study all the subjects, because questions are coming from all the sections. So you can prioritize, you can give priority to other topics, other subjects. Like my priority is economics, your priority is history, but you cannot remove any subject entirely. So that is the point. Okay, so like that way we'll be uploading videos. Now we have already uploaded few videos on Indian polity. You can go to my channel and you can go to the playlist. So there will be an option Indian polity, there will be some option history, geography. So videos are listed in a separate playlist, so you can go to that playlist and you can have videos one by one. Now we'll be uploading videos. Now we come to the routine. So we have chosen weekend, Saturday and Sunday. We'll be uploading regular videos on Saturday and Sunday, and then if required, if I get time, then we'll be uploading video on weekdays. Okay, but we don't have any plan to make any live sessions because of lack of students. Once we get a good amount of students, rather I can say good amount of friends, then I can start my preparation, I can start making live videos. Okay, so if you have any queries, you can write in the below comment section. We just want to make the session interactive. It's not like that I'm giving you lecture and you have to listen to me. If I am wrong, you can write in the below comment section that I'm wrong. But that now, anyway, we have to prepare for the civil service WBC, civil service of Bengal. Okay, so today's topic, let me start today's topic. Today we'll be discussing on basic things of economics. Now, what are the things you need to study in economics that is important? If you do not know the topics, how do you prepare for it? It's not possible. So in economics, first of all, you have to know what is economics. Economics means this is a study of market. This is a real event, this is a real problem, real challenge. Suppose I am taking an example. Suppose I have a stock market. What happens in stock market? There are some brokers. What they do? They sell shares or stake of some companies. Suppose this is share market. Now it is happening electronically, but still I'm telling in the past what happened. Actually there are many companies listed, say 1, 2, 3, 4, say there are this 4 different companies, say A, B, C, D. Now what they do, basically those are called public limited companies. Now what is public limited company? There are three kinds of companies. One is private, public limited, and other is government sector. Now what is government sector? A sector which is owned by government of India or government of any states, that is your government company. Like Indian Railway. Indian Railway is a government company, or it's a government organization. Now what is private company? Suppose I own a company, I have started a company, this is my company, or 5 or 6 friends, we join together and we start a company. That is private limited company. Now what is public limited company? Public limited company means we started a company that is going fine. Now what we want to do? We want to sell our share. Our share means, suppose a company has 3 partners, that means 33.33% of share of each person. Now what I want to do, I want to sell 20% of the share to the market. What does it mean? I'll tell people to give me money and I will give you the share of profit. So our company is doing some business, so what I am doing, I am taking money from the market, 20% of my company's expenditure I am taking from market, and whatever profit I am making, the percentage I am giving to the shareholders. So like that way, we give share to the market, and ordinary people becomes a part of the company, and that is called share. And any company which is doing this thing, that is a public limited. Okay, so I guess the things are clear now. So economics is the study of this market, not only share market, it may be a fruit market, it may be a vegetable market, it may be any market. So how the demand and supply is changing, what are the factors that determine the price of a product, all these things we study in economics. Now you need to know few definition. This is an introductory class. What is microeconomics and what is macroeconomics? Now from the term itself you can see what does micro mean. Micro mean small. What does macro mean? Macro means large, but compared to small it is bigger. So study of a market which is definite, like I want to study the condition of Kolkata Boro Bazar market. Okay, so that comes under microeconomics because we are only thinking of a particular market. But if I want to study regarding the market of India, how the business condition is in India, that becomes the topic of macro. That is called actually macroeconomics. So I guess the things are now clear. So there might be a question, what is macroeconomics, what is microeconomics. Now whenever you are studying economics, then you need to know few terminologies, and that is, we sometimes say capitalistic market. Now what is capitalistic market? What is socialist principle? What is capitalist principle? Capitalist principle. So those things are important. Now socialist principle means we don't have any private or public limited company. Everything is owned by government. Whatever government is deciding, we have to do. Anybody is doing any business, he has to inform government, and government has some procedures, government has some rules, and you have to follow those rules. So everything is owned by government. That is called socialism. And in socialist economics, everybody has same rights. Suppose there will be no social disbalance between the among the people. Like in a company, there are CEOs, there are managers, and there are laborers. But in socialists, there will also be CEO, laborers, and everything. But everybody will get same amount of money. That is the concept of socialism. So whatever you are doing, you will be getting equal profit margin for your work. So that is the concept of socialism or socialist economy. And what is capitalist economy? In capitalist economy, what happens? You invest something for a particular business and you earn some money. So suppose I invest, so I'll be the maximum gainer. Now when I invest, when I want to do something, I need people. So what do? I hire people, and the people will be skilled, semi-skilled, and maybe I need engineers, maybe I need marketer, maybe I need people from management. So the people from management will get higher salary compared to the people who are doing the basic, doing the jobs or doing the labor kind of jobs. So they will get minimum money. So there is a slab. People who are working, they are getting little amount of money, people who are doing the management, they are getting more money. So like that way, there will be a difference. And that is the concept of capitalism. So I have money and I invest in the market. So I am a capitalist. Okay. So this is the concept of capitalism. So few, these are the basic things you need to know. So now you may ask me, which one is better? Socialist economy is better or capitalist economy is better? Now I'll give you one example. Suppose in you may think that socialist is better because everybody will get equal profit. But this is not the fact, because suppose we are preparing for WBCS examination. Why? Because you know, if we get this job, then we'll have a social respect, we'll have money, we'll have some other value. So we dream for it, and that's why you prepare for WBCS examination. But if I tell you, you be WBCS officer, you be a clerk in a bank, you be a daily laborer, you'll get same amount of money, then will you prepare for WBCS examination? No, you will not be preparing for it. Because you know, what is the point of preparing, what is the point of working so hard? Because ultimately we'll be getting same amount of money. So, if there is no competition, there will be no work. You people will not be working. So, socialist economy actually does not work. Now, what is the problem in capitalist economy? In capitalist economy also there is a problem. The problem is the people who have money, they invest, they are becoming rich and rich, and the people who are working for them, they are becoming more poor. This is a bad thing. At the same time, there are good points, like if I invest, then I'll recruit people, people will be getting jobs. Like suppose you see the city of Bangalore, Mumbai, there are lots of shopping malls, lots of KFC and all the things are there. So a huge amount of people are working for them and they are getting money, and they are actually spending their career, their life in a better way. So we have TCS, we have CTS, we have KFCs, we have shopping malls like Big Bazaar and all. Because of that we have jobs, and that's why it's a good thing to go for capitalist economy. But both the extreme is not good. You have to stay in between this capitalist and socialist economy. So we'll be coming in detail. So this is the introductory class. Hope that the things which I discuss will help you. So if it helps, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.